SVT stands for supraventricular tachycardia. The way that I describe arrhythmias to my patients is there are two sets of arrhythmias that come from the top of the heart that are dangerous. They can increase the risk of stroke, they increase the risk of heart failure. That's atrial fibrillation and atrial flutter. There's a whole different set of rhythms called SVT. In SVT, there's three common types of arrhythmias. These rhythms affect quality of life. They tend not to increase the risk of stroke. They don't cause heart failure, but they can make people feel very bad. And a lot of times, I've had patients who are diagnosed with panic attacks or anxiety because they're having these episodes where their heart's racing, and actually what they have is SVT. The natural history of SVT is over time, it tends to get worse and worse. Sometimes these start in childhood, sometimes they start in teenage years, sometimes they start later in life. But the typical patient that we have who has SVT has no high blood pressure, has no diabetes, has no real medical problems. They simply have a heart rhythm abnormality in the top of their heart that usually they were born with. Sometimes this is an extra nerve or pathway in the heart that causes these arrhythmias. Sometimes it's sites in the heart that spontaneously fire on their own at certain times. The treatment options for that is either to take a medicine lifelong to try to suppress the arrhythmia. And the way that I describe that to people is, imagine having dust on your floor at home and you sweep it under a rug. Well, it's still under the rug. The only option you have to completely eliminate the arrhythmia forever is to do an ablation. And the nice thing is, the ablation procedure is about a 2-hour procedure. Depending on the arrhythmia, it has greater than a 90% likelihood of curing the arrhythmia and you never have it again. And once the procedure is done, other than taking aspirin for several weeks afterwards, there's no long-term medication that you have to take. The typical recommendation is to be pretty aggressive with these arrhythmias. Instead of taking lifelong medicine when you're 25 or 30 years old, you can go in and actually ablate the arrhythmia, never have it again, and go home 3 or 4 hours after the procedure is completed.